Our help is in the name of the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Good morning. This morning we celebrate the solemnity of Pentecost, 50 days after Easter. So let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Lord, bless us with the wisdom to praise you in spirit and in truth, so that by following your holy will we may gain eternal salvation. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment, confess our sins to God in ways that we have failed him and our neighbor in thought, word, deed, and omission, so that we may worthily participate in this holy sacrifice. Please now make an examination of your conscience. Now let's say together the second form of the Confiteor found on page 66. I confess to Almighty God, in the presence of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned through my own fault, in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done or failed to do. I ask the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. For your penance, I would ask you to do an act of kindness for someone else sometime in the next couple of days. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. May our Lord Jesus Christ absolve you, and with his authority vested in me, I absolve you from all of your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. For the Spirit of the Lord fills the world, is all-embracing, and knows what man says. Alleluia. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Holy Spirit, giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, have mercy on us. As you descended upon the disciples in the upper room, so now once again descend on your church. Inflame our hearts, enlighten our minds, and purify our souls. For together with the Father and the Son, you live and reign one God forever and ever. Please be seated for our first reading.
The first reading is from the Acts of the Apostles. When the time for Pentecost was fulfilled, they were all in one place together, and suddenly there came from the sky a noise like a strong driving wind, and it filled the entire house in which they were. Then there appeared to them tongues as of fire, which parted and came to rest on each one of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and began to speak in different tongues, as the Spirit enabled them to proclaim. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven staying in Jerusalem. At this sound, they gathered in a large crowd, but they were confused because each one heard them speaking in his own language. They were astounded, and in amazement, they asked, "Are not all these people who are speaking Galileans? Then how does each of us hear them in his native language? We are Parthians, Medes, and Elamites, inhabitants of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the districts of Libya near Cyrene, as well as travelers from Rome, both Jews and converts to Judaism, Cretans and Arabs. Yet we hear them speaking in our own tongues of the mighty acts of God." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please respond. Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, my God, you are great indeed. How manifold are your works, O Lord. The earth is full of your creatures.
Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
If you take away their breath, they perish and return to their dust. When you send forth their spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth.
Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord be glad in his works. Pleasing to him by my theme, I will be glad in the Lord.
Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
The second reading is a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, no one can say Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. There are different kinds of spiritual gifts, but the same Spirit. There are different forms of service, but the same Lord. There are different workings, but the same God, who produces all of them in everyone. To each individual, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for some benefit. As a body is one through it has many parts, all the parts of the body, though many, are one body. So also Christ. For in one Spirit we are all baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, slaves or free persons, and we were all given to drink of one Spirit. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please remain seated. Come, Holy Spirit, come, and from your celestial home, shed a ray of light divine. Come, Father of the poor, come, source of all our store, come, within our bosoms shine. You of comforters the best, you the soul's most welcome guest, sweet refreshment here below. In our labor, rest most sweet, grateful coolness in the heat, solace in the midst of woe. O most blessed light divine, shine within the hearts of yours and our inmost being, Phil. Where you are not, man has not. Nothing good in deed or thought. Nothing free from taint of ill. Heal our wounds, our strength renew. On our dryness pour your dew. Wash the stains of guilt away. Bend the stubborn heart and will. Melt the frozen, warm the chill. Guide the steps that go astray. On the faithful who adore and confess you evermore, in your sevenfold gift descend. Give them virtue's sure reward. Give them your salvation, Lord. Give them joys that never end. Amen. Alleluia.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. I will pour out my spirit upon all humankind. Your sons and daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. Your young men shall see visions. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained."
This is the gospel of the Lord.
And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit." These words are taken from today's gospel according to St. John, in the name of the Father, the Son, of the Holy Spirit. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, today, as I mentioned, we celebrate Pentecost. Literally, that means 50 days. So 50 days after Easter. But we're not the first ones as Christians to celebrate Pentecost. In Hebrew, the 50 days is pronounced Shavuot. That is 50 days after the second day after Passover, Pentecost for the Jews. And that is their harvest festival. So when the apostles, the 11, were gathered in that upper room with the doors locked, it was during the feast of Shavuot, where all the people from all over had come to Jerusalem. And so when the Holy Spirit came during the harvest festival, it kind of gives a new meaning to what was happening. Now in the vigil readings, we heard about the Tower of Babel, when they're trying to build that tower to heaven and all the languages came about. But today we hear the conclusion of that when the Holy Spirit gives the apostles the the ability to speak languages they didn't know before and proclaim the gospel to everybody. Parthians, Medes, Elamites, Mesopotamians, Judeans, Cappadocians, and so on and so on. They all heard the gospel in their own language for the first time. And that was God's harvest beginning. Because bringing everybody to the truths of our Savior is what the Holy Spirit does. The Holy Spirit gives us many gifts and fruits, some of them courage, some of them counsel, wisdom, and so forth. But they're all meant to bring all humankind back to our Lord. That's why Jesus suffered and died. That's why he established his church and sent the Holy Spirit to guide it all these years from then till now and beyond. So as we celebrate this beautiful solemnity, let us open our hearts to receive the Holy Spirit every day so that we may be strengthened and live those gifts and go forth and bring as many people as possible back to our Lord. And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit." In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us now turn to page 71 and say together the creed that unites us as Christians. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you. Relying on the Spirit, who always intercedes for us, let us turn to the Lord with our prayers of petition. Our response will be, "Come, Holy Spirit, come."
For the church, that this Pentecost may bring a renewed sense of unity in the body of Christ with all Christians around the world, we pray to the Lord.
Come, Holy Spirit, come.
That the Spirit of peace will put an end to war, violence, and division in our world, and for leaders at the national, state, and local levels, that they may be inspired by the fruits and gifts of the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Come, Holy Spirit, come.
For graduates and all those with new journeys ahead, that they may be attentive to the guidance of the Holy Spirit and use their gifts wisely in the service to others, we pray to the Lord.
Come, Holy Spirit, come.
For a new outpouring of the Holy Spirit in our lives, in our families, and in our parish community, we pray to the Lord.
Come, Holy Spirit, come.
For all who are sick, especially those on the parish prayer list, that the breath of the Spirit's love may come upon them, restoring them in health and wholeness, we pray to the Lord.
Come, Holy Spirit, come.
For the personal intentions we hold deep in the silence of our hearts. And for whom this Mass is offered, for the repose of the soul of the Right Reverend Jerry Rafalco, we pray to the Lord.
Come, Holy Spirit, come.
For all who have died and those who will die today, that they may be welcomed with joy into the fullness of God's presence, we pray to the Lord.
Come, Holy Spirit, come. Loving God, help us to experience the Spirit's presence in us and among us more deeply. We ask all these things through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of that same Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. When the Advocate comes, whom I will send you from the Father, the Spirit of truth that proceeds from the Father, he will not speak on his own. He will take from what is mine and give it to you. Alleluia. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, through your goodness, wine, bread to offer, which has given human hands, and may become for us the bread of life. The mystery of this wine. And water, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, may become our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Come, Holy Spirit, and bless the sacrifice to prepare for the glory of your holy name. Lord, wash away my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sin. See this offering, most holy Trinity, which we make in memory of the Passion, Resurrection, and Ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ, and in honor of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints. May they, whose memory we honor on earth, intercede for us in heaven. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Holy Spirit, Comforter and Advocate, sanctify our gifts. Guide us in truth, defend us from evil, and enrich us with grace. For together with the Father and the Son, you live and reign, one God, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. On this day you sent the Holy Spirit upon the apostles to establish your church, completing the Paschal mystery and revealing your plan of salvation in Christ. Today we celebrate the birth of your church, through which the Holy Spirit unites all generations of your faithful people, who, out of many languages, profess in one voice the one true faith. Therefore, with the angels and archangels, with all the saints and the entire church, we lift our hymn of praise to your glory, repeating unceasingly. Blessed is he who comes in the name. Holy Sacrifice of the Mass continues with Eucharistic Prayer 3, which is found on page 84, and this is the final Sunday we will remain standing for the Eucharistic Prayer. We claim you, Holy Lord, glorious in power. Your mighty works reveal your wisdom and love. You have formed us in your own image, giving the whole world into our care, so that, in obedience to you, our Creator, we might rule and serve all your creatures. When our disobedience took us far from you, you did not abandon us to the power of death. In your mercy, you came to our help so that in seeking you, we might find you. Again and again, you called us into covenant with you, and through the prophets, you taught us to hope for salvation. Gracious God, you loved the world so much that in the fullness of time, you sent your only Son to be our Savior. Incarnate by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, he lived as one of us, yet without sin. To the poor, he proclaimed the good news of salvation, the prisoner's freedom, the sorrowful joy. To fulfill your purpose, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the grave, destroyed death, and made the whole creation new. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose for us, he sent the Holy Spirit, his own first gift for those who believe, to complete his work in the world, and to bring to fulfillment the sanctification of all. When the hour had come for him to be glorified, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. At supper with them, he took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which is given for you." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which shall be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you do this, do it in remembrance of me." We now celebrate the memorial of our redemption, recalling Christ's death and descent among the dead, proclaiming his resurrection and ascension to your right hand, awaiting his coming in glory, and offering to you from the gifts you have given us, this bread and this cup, we praise you and bless you together. We praise you, we bless you, we give thanks to you, and we pray to you, Lord our God. We pray that in your goodness and mercy, your Holy Spirit may descend upon us and upon these gifts, sanctifying them and showing them to be holy gifts for your holy people, the bread of life and the cup of salvation, the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Pray that all who share this bread and this cup may become one body and one spirit, a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your name. Remember your one holy Catholic and apostolic church redeemed by the blood of your Christ. Reveal its unity, guard its faith, and preserve it in peace. Remember Anthony, our prime bishop, Charles, our administrator, and all who minister in your church. Remember all your people and those who seek your truth, especially those on our parish prayer list. Remember all who have died in the peace of Christ, whose faith is known to you alone, especially Bishop Jerry, for whom we offer this Mass. Bring them into the place of eternal joy and light, and grant that we may find our inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, with our ancestors in faith, with the prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and all the saints who have found favor with you in ages past. We praise you in union with them and give you glory through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, all honor and glory are yours, Creator of all, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever.
Page 95, let us pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior gave us.
Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The cup of blessing which we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread which we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ?
As there is one bread, we who are many are one body, for we all partake of the one bread.
May the union of divinity and humanity in Jesus Christ bring us sanctification and eternal life. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Do not look at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Let's say together the First Communion prayer found on page 97. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, free me from all my sins and from every evil. Keep me faithful to your teaching and never let me be parted from you. I will take the bread of heaven and call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring me to everlasting life. May the blood of Christ bring me to everlasting life. For those who are joining us online or who for personal reasons cannot receive the body and blood of Christ today, please join me now in the act of spiritual communion. Most loving Jesus, I adore you in the most blessed sacrament in which you are truly present. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart and heal my soul. I embrace you, unite myself with you, and I never be separated from you. Inflame my heart with the fire of your love, my Lord and Savior. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the table of the Lord. The body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. The body of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ.
puts the next breath in my lungs. He pours that new wine in my cup. I can't stop singing of all he's done. His mercies are new every morning.
When you send forth your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth. Alleluia.
Let us pray. Holy Spirit, our comforter, through this holy Eucharist, grant us a new vision and a new counsel, new wisdom and fresh understanding, the revival of our piety and the renewal of our fortitude. So may we go forth from this place, faithful in service and fruitful in deeds. Establish in us the knowledge of God and in the fear of the Lord, that we may see the kingdom of heaven upon the earth. For together with the Father and the Son, you live and reign with one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen. For the final time this year,
go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
It is a great pleasure to be able to dedicate this beautiful tabernacle. When we realized that there were many memorial donations given in honor of Bishop Jerry, we realized that this was the opportunity to posthumously make his dream of having a safe, sturdy brass tabernacle at Holy Trinity come true to protect the Blessed Sacrament from any type of desecration. This tabernacle was given in memory of the Right Reverend Jaroslav Jerry Rafalko by many of his friends, supporters, and family, and was installed by a generous donation of work and skill by Mike Kabinski. We are thankful to all those people. As we have consecrated the tabernacle for use, we now dedicate this tabernacle, and we also have a memorial plaque that we had engraved. It says, dedicated to the memory of Right Reverend Jaroslav Jerry Rafalko, pastor 1990 to 2020, Western Diocese Bishop 2020 to 2023. Jesus took bread, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which is given for you. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, whose Son, Jesus Christ, gave us the sacrament of his body and blood, grant that all who pray before the Blessed Sacrament in this tabernacle and all who receive the sacred body contained herein, which we now dedicate for us in your church, may be sustained by his presence and enjoy forever the riches of his blessings. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, in unity with the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Now I would like to invite Leslie to come up and say a few words.
Father John, my dear sisters and brothers in Christ, thank you so much for your presence during the dedication of this columbarium.
Tabernacle.
Of the tabernacle. As we recall, last year in October, our beloved Holy Trinity Church organized memorial service for Bishop Jerry, and we received generous donations from parishioners, friends, and neighbors, and the Holy Trinity Church, under the guidance of Father John, decided to buy a new tabernacle in his memory. So thank you so much for all monetary donations, and from the bottom of my heart, thank you so much for people, time, talent, who organized this event, and plan and prepare and help with everything. For sure, this is beautiful. Bishop Jerry likes it, for sure. And he's watching over us. He was an amazing human being. He was, for you, neighbors and friends, he was like a father, mother, a neighbor, and if needed, he picked you up on his shoulders and was carried you to lessen your burdens. I have just a little something to read. As some people journey through life, they leave footprints wherever they go. Footprints of kindness and love, courage and compassion, humor and inspiration, joy and faith. Even when they are gone, we can still look back and clearly see the trail they left behind, a trail bright with hope that invites us to follow. So he left us many trails that we need to follow. I wanted to invite you to Chicago for July 13. It will be 1 year anniversary of Bishop passing. There will be anniversary mass, 11 o'clock in the cathedral, All Saints Cathedral. And also the monument company promised that the Bishop Jerry Columbarium, therefore I got confused at the beginning, the Bishop Jerry Columbarium will be ready. And during this time, right after mass, we will go to the cemetery. This is just a few steps over, and we are going to put him to his everlasting place. And after this, everybody is invited for lunch. downstairs in the church hall. So one more time, thank you so much. And May is Mother's Day month. In United States, we celebrate this second Sunday of May. In Poland, we celebrate always May 26. So for all moms here, I just prepare small gifts for you. Love you guys. Bishop Jerry will love you too. Thank you for your help. Thank you, Father John. Thank you so much for help.
Please join me now in the prayer of St. Michael. Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to you, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. I'd like to ask you to keep Bishop Jerry and Leslie in your prayers. And thank you. Have a very wonderful Sunday.